Welcome. In this tutorial, we will solve this maximization problem using graphical method. Let's label the constraints C1 to C4 for reference purposes. Let's start by setting up tables to find the points. The line equation for constraint 1 is 7x minus y equals 3. So when x equals 0, y equals negative 3. And when y equals 0, x equals 0.43. These two points are not that useful to us because the first has a negative, which will take us far away from the feasible region and make the graph very small. The other has a fractional value that cannot be easily located on the graph. So let's try finding more points. To make it easy to find useful points, it is better to rewrite the equation in terms of one variable. In this case, we write it in terms of y. That is, y equals 7x minus 3. We can now use trial and error to find better points. For example, when x equals 0.5, y also equals 0.5. And when x equals 1, y equals 4. For constraint 2, we have the line negative 3x plus 6y equals 10. When x equals 0, y equals 1.67. And when y equals 0, x equals negative 3.33. Again, let's try more points. Rewriting the equation, we have 6y equals 10 plus 3x. So that y equals 10 plus 3x divided by 6. When x equals 1, y equals 2.17. And when x equals 2, y equals 2.67. So it is hard to find whole number points for this line. For constraint 3, we have the line 3x plus 4y equals 9. When x equals 0, y equals 2.25. And when y equals 0, x equals 3. Let's try one more point. When x equals 1, y equals 1.5. And finally, for constraint 4, we have the line 3x plus 3y equals 3. So when x equals 0, y equals 1. And when y equals 0, x equals 1. And that should do it for that constraint. In drawing the line for the first constraint, we can just plot the last two points, 0.5, 0.5, and 1, 4, and then the constraint line. For the second constraint, we can use the first point and the last two, and that's the line. For the third constraint, we can use 3, 0, and 1, 1.5, and that's the line. For the fourth constraint, we have 0, 1, and 1, 0, and that's the line. Now, the first three constraints are less than constraints and are satisfied in the direction of the origin. The last constraint is a greater than constraint satisfied in this direction away from the origin. The directions of the arrows show that the feasible region is this shaded area in blue. To determine which of the extreme points of this feasible region is optimal, let's use the objective function line method. The objective function is to maximize negative 3x plus 12y. We begin by setting the objective function to any number of our choice. Normally, I would just multiply 3 by 12, but that would give us 36, which would give us a line too far away from the feasible region. But since 12 is a multiple of 3, it would be a better choice in this case. So let's set the objective function equal to 12. Next, we find points to draw the objective function line. When x equals 0, y equals 1. And when y equals 0, x equals negative 4. Because of this negative 4, let's just obtain one more point. When x equals 2, y equals 1.5. So using these two points, the objective function line is this dotted line here. Since this is a maximization problem, we slowly move the objective function line upwards away from the origin parallel to itself to obtain the optimal solution point. Now, moving the objective function line shows that the optimal solution occurs here at the line intersection of constraint 2 and 3. Let us now solve these two lines simultaneously to determine the coordinates at that point. Here are the equations. Since the coefficients of x in the two equations are negative 3 and positive 3 respectively, we can simply add the two equations to eliminate x. So negative 3x cancels 3x. 6y plus 4y gives 10y, and 10 plus 9 gives 19. On dividing both sides by 10, we have y equals 1.9. Substituting that value of y in C3, we have 3x plus 4 times 1.9 equals 9. That is, 3x equals 1.4 and x equals 0.47. So the optimal solution is x equals 0.47 and y equals 1.9. Plugging that point into the objective function, we have negative 3 times 0.47 plus 12 times 1.9, which gives 21.4. So the optimal solution is x equals 0.47 and y equals 1.9. And the corresponding maximum value of the objective function is 21.4. See you in the next video, and thanks for watching.